gentlemen, welcome into OCW Renegade episode 14. My name is Drake Stacy, your color commentator for tonight's action. And as always, tonight we want to welcome you all into OCW Renegade 14 as the road to immortalization continues on. We are just a few weeks away from the biggest show of the year, and we want to thank each and every one of you who has tuned in for the live premiere here tonight. If you are a new viewer here to OCW, please give this channel a subscribe. Follow us on all forms of social media. Hit that bell icon to keep up with all things OCW, ladies and gentlemen. You will not want to miss a second of the action. As immortalization, as I said, is on the horizon line, ladies and gentlemen. It is going to be one hell of a show. The card will be continuously revealed as we go throughout the process of Renegade, and I'm excited to have each and every one of you here watching alongside. And ladies and gentlemen, a big match is set for tonight's main event for the NXT Championship in an Extreme Rules All or Nothing match. AJ Reyes challenges Manny Lopez, and these two men finally collide, and only one will walk away with the OCW NXT Championship when the dust settles, ladies and gentlemen. Also tonight, ladies and gentlemen, announced by our general manager in a number one contenders match for the Intercontinental Championship, Brent Storm challenges FJA. One of them goes to immortalization to face off for the IC title. Then, later on tonight, ladies and gentlemen, we will see Strong Style Jacob Steele going up against MCL. These two men do not like each other, and this is going to be a hard-hitting affair, ladies and gentlemen. But we start tonight, ladies and gentlemen, with two women making their proper in-ring debuts, who both debuted at the Royal Rumble this 2 weeks ago. Mia Suzuki versus Lilith Shane. That is how we get it going here tonight, ladies and gentlemen. What a way to kick us off. It's going to be one hell of a match, one hell of a show, and let's waste no more time. Let's jump into it. And making her way down to the ring first, ladies and gentlemen, representing the EWF. This woman made her debut at the Royal Rumble from the number two position. One of the fastest rising stars in the women's division in UCT today. This is Mia Suzuki. Mia Suzuki made her debut in both the OCW and the XWF from the number two position. I genuinely couldn't believe it when Mia came out at number two at that show. It was one hell of a show. If you have not checked out the XWF Gladiators Gauntlet, it was one of the best CPVs of the year so far, by far, ladies and gentlemen. And Mia Suzuki made an impact in the Women's Gladiators Gauntlet match, as well as she made an impact in the OCW Royal Rumble, and now she is looking to make an impact here in OCW as she looks to climb the ranks in a singles win here tonight on her proper in-ring debut. Will be a great start for Mia, because, you know, it's just, you want to start off your career here in OCW and anywhere you go for that matter with a singles victory. It sets the bar. It lets everybody know exactly what you are all about. But Mia Suzuki, that win is not going to come easy, young lady. You are going to have to work for it. That is for sure. And making her way down to the ring next, ladies and gentlemen, Mia Suzuki's opponent for tonight, representing the AEW. This woman made her debut in the Royal Rumble as well from the number 17 position. This is Lilith Shane. I am personally a big fan of Lilith Shane. I have been a fan of hers ever since I saw her work in the ACW. If you have not checked out the ACW, ladies and gentlemen, I highly recommend you do. It is a up and coming promotion, a Gen 3 show, and I'm very excited to see the future of ACW as well. And Lilith Shade representing that company proudly as she makes her entry into the Renegade Arena for the first time in her career. This woman has been on our radars for a couple of months now, and we are very excited that we were able to get a deal done. And, you know, Lilith Shade joining the full-time women's roster alongside other ACW counterpart Sarah Ephist. The women's division in UCT, ladies and gentlemen, and in OCW is growing by the day, and you absolutely love to see it. The women have been showing up and showing out, and everybody recognizes there is a surge in the women's division happening across the board in UCT. And again, you love to see it. Now, these two gonna get us going here for Renegade. For Renegade 14, again, both making their official OCW in-ring debut. As both ladies are ready for the task at hand here, ladies and gentlemen. And here we go. This match is on. Lilith Shade starting off with a couple of shots there to Mia Suzuki in the dead center of the ring. Look at Lilith Shade. Rolls it through with a hurricane run. Lilith Shade coming out strong. Establish dominance. Establish your presence in that ring, Lilith Shade. That's what you got to do. There's a drop down fireman's carry counter there by Mia Suzuki from the knees. Couple of shots there from Mia. Mia now going to send her in the top left corner. Big boot out of in the corner by Mia Suzuki. A quick cover first of the night on Lilith Shade. That's one. That's two. Kick out there by Lilith Shade. That big kick in the corner, that haluva kick, will definitely ring your bell and keep you down. That's for sure, ladies and gentlemen, but it was not enough. And there's Lilith Shade with the deep arm drag. Counter big shot there from Lilith, dropping Mia Suzuki. That's one, that's two. Kick out at two by Mia Suzuki. That big shot from Lilith Shade really ringing the bell of Mia Suzuki, but not enough. Here comes Mia with a forearm smash. Mia gets blocked here by Lilith. Lilith with a forearm smash of her own. Another forearm smash there from Lilith. These two women not backing down to each other. Backs her down does Mia Suzuki. Irish Whip gonna send Lilith off the left hand side. Deep arm drag counter off the Irish Whip there by Mia. Mia now gonna head up top to the middle rope here. Lilith Shade slowly being brought to her feet. Here comes Mia with a missile drop kick from the middle. Nice move there from Mia Suzuki as a quick cover here on Lilith Shade. That's one, that's two. Kick out by Lilith Shade at two. Great back and forth action here in this contest between these two women. There's a shot from Mia Suzuki. Mia coming in with a couple of shots, and that gets blocked by Lilith Shade. Lilith Shade with the right hand, with a right forearm smash. Nice takedown there from Lilith. Lilith now has control of Mia. She sends her into the bottom right-hand corner this time. Here is Lilith Shade. Lilith up on the middle. Has Mia hooked up. Look at this. Nice move there from Lilith Shade. Innovative offense from Lilith with that suplex off the middle rope. And now going to drag her by her legs toward the center of the ring is Lilith Shade. And Lilith Shade snapping the left leg there of Mia Suzuki. Trying to wear down Mia best she can. Any offense is good offense. Snap suplex there from Lilith Shade. Lilith stringing together a couple of moves in succession. And Mia Suzuki really needs to find her way back into it. And hits another snap suplex. Does Lilith Shade. Lilith Shade looking good here in this part of the contest here. She's just lining Mia Suzuki up. Possibly looking for another third suplex. No, this time Mia Suzuki able to counter it there. Mia Suzuki able to counter. Spinning back fist there from Mia Suzuki. Lilith Shade feeling the effects of that spinning back fist. Now here comes Mia Suzuki. Sends Lilith out to the middle. Lilith seated in the center of the ring. Mia with a drop kick from the top. Mia with a drop kick to the seated position. Lilith Shade has a cannonball sent out to follow from Mia Suzuki. A quick cover following that on Lilith Shade to put Lilith away. No. That was a good opportunity for Mia Suzuki to put Lilith Shade away, but it was not enough. It is not to be. This contest is still underway, ladies and gentlemen. And now here's Mia Suzuki overhead belly to belly suplex. Great power from Mia Suzuki. So Suzuki now gonna bring Lilith Shade up to a vertical base, sending her into the top, bottom left-hand corner this time is Mia Suzuki. Mia Suzuki now gonna swing the legs out swing the legs out a little shade, and now here's Mia. Here's Mia from the top. Mia from the top with Lilith Superplex. Look at this! Rolls it through! Falcon Arrow! High-reaching cover with the leg to put Lilith away! Kicked out from Lilith! Lilith Shade barely got the shoulder up it too. She got the shoulder up, and now Mia Suzuki calling her shot, lining Lilith Shade up, following the top rope superplex. Falcon Arrow combination drop kick there from Lilith Shade on Mia Suzuki. Lilith Shade not going to give Mia Suzuki any room to get the advantage, and now Lilith Shade just wrenching the body. Look at this, just using the ropes for a little extra torque to really put that pressure on the back and arms. Kick to the knee there by Lilith Shade. Lilith off the ropes. Look at this! Spike Rana there by Lilith. Lilith a cover here to put Mia Suzuki away! No! Lilith Shade unable to put her down with the Spike Rana. Now calling her to her feet one more time. Looking for that home run hit to put Mia Suzuki away. No, kick to the midsection there by Mia. Mia fighting back on Lilith. Oh my God. Oh my God. Half and Mia Suzuki vaults the top with the senton. Mia Suzuki, incredible. Really staying on the offense is Mia Suzuki. Mia Suzuki now up on the apron. The referee's count has begun. Mia can be counted out from the apron there. From the apron, and now here's Mia Suzuki from the top. Front drop kick beats its mark right on the jaw of Lilith Shade. A cover to put Lilith away. No! Lilith kicks out at two, shot to the back, but Lilith immediately up to her feet, rolls it through to Lilith, nice move! Nice move from Lilith Shade, kick to the midsection, sunset flip powerbomb, cover to put Mia away, kick out from Mia Suzuki at 2.5. Lilith Shade thought she had her right there. A great back and forth contest between these two women here. Forearm smash there from Mia Suzuki. Mia Suzuki now gonna send Lilith Shade hard to the outside. Lilith in a bad position here as Mia Suzuki measures Mia off the ropes. Mia! Cannonball senton through the middle. Between the top and middle rope, Mia Suzuki throws caution to the wind and gets all of it, reaps the rewards, and now Mia Suzuki firmly in the driver's seat following that try. Now brings her into the middle, into the ring. Now bringing Lilith Shade up to a vertical base, goes around. Look at this double underhook. Oh my God, what a powerbomb. A cover on Lilith Shade to put her away. Kick out by Lilith. What will it take to put the other two away? This match means a lot to both of them. To get your first singles victory in OCW is huge. Here comes Mia for the senton. Rolled out of the way, did Lilith. Lilith rolled out of the way. Begins a curry to a kneeling Mia Suzuki. Now brings her up to Lilith. Lilith rolls it through. Another kick. Another kick from Lilith. As Mia rolls to the outside, she is on the apron pulling herself up, using the ropes to pull herself up. And Lilith with a stunner, a top rope stunner. Now what the hell, Lilith Shade on the top. Oh my God. Oh my God, a senton. A senton from the top to the outside by Lilith. Mia Suzuki in a bad way here. Mia Suzuki in a very bad way here. A cover to put Mia Suzuki away. Two! Kick out by Mia! 2.8! Mia Suzuki gets the shoulder up! And now Mia Suzuki in a bad spot here. If Lilith connects with the finish, it's over. It's over. No! No! Pushes her away. Does Mia Suzuki kick to the leg? Here comes Mia Coppola. Rapid fire kicks to the chest of Lilith Shade. It's a curry roundhouse. The roundhouse kick there by Mia Mia Suzuki as Lilla Shane gets pulled, pulling herself up once again. And now Mia Suzuki sends Lilla Shane over. She holds on. Mia spears Lilla. Mia Suzuki spears Lilla through the ropes. What a match between these two. Mia Suzuki brings Lilla Shane into the ring, now up to a vertical base. Look at this! Mia Suzuki tombstone pile driver! A tombstone pile driver from Lilla, from Mia Suzuki! Now Mia has her position up on the hands for last ride power bomb! Last ride power bomb by Mia Suzuki. Cover to put her away. That's one. That's two. Mia Suzuki wins her debut. Take nothing away from Lilith Shane. An amazing effort. Amazing opening contest between these two, and if that is the taste, if that's the sample of what we should expect from those two women going forward here in OCW, the women's division's future is bright. Ladies and gentlemen, congratulations to Mia Suzuki on an incredible opening contest, and welcome to OCW, both Mia Suzuki and Lilla Shane. Stay a while. Very excited to see what the future holds for those two women, ladies and gentlemen. Now we're going backstage with Steel. Steel laying down the challenge, and he apparently wants to face MCL right here, right now. Is this going to happen? Well, I guess it is. Ladies and gentlemen, we are moving into our next contest here for OCW Renegade, and making his entry into the OCW arena, the former OCW champion, Strong Style Jacob Steel is here. Jacob Steel competed last week in the All or Nothing qualifiers, and he came up short against Arrow, who made his proper in-ring return here to OCW, and his opponent tonight, MCL. He also had a qualifying match, but MCL is going to immortalization. He will be in the eight-man All or Nothing ladder match after he defeated OCW staple, OCW veteran, legend of the game, the Ninja. And now these two men, they have been at odds for a couple of weeks now, ever since MCL debuted and he took out Steel's former partner, Punisher Ron. Jacob Steel has been, you know, he is not like MCL too much, but now Jacob Steel, he finds himself in the line of fire once again, but he's coming after MCL anyway. And making his way down to the ring, ladies and gentlemen, he is a former two-time NXT champion. This is MCL. MCL has set the world on fire since he has come here to OCW. He has not taken a pinfall or submission loss since his return. He's only had a couple of matches, but he's looked damn good doing it. You know, and now he's got an opportunity to be the winner of the third ever All or Nothing ladder match, but he has to get through Strong Style Jacob Steele here tonight before he can get to that match. Remember, the winner of this match, if Strong Style were to win this match tonight against MCL, he does not take MCL's place in the All or Nothing ladder match. MCL is going to immortalization, and that is a huge opportunity for that young man because he is stepping into the ring with some of the most talented guys UCT has to offer today. Guys like Brendan and Victor X, Jack Roberts, Jonathan Morgan, Dark Storm, Arrow. The list goes on. It is going to be one hell of a match. And MCL, you know, any little bit of momentum he can try and acquire before that match is good momentum. And can he defeat Strong Style Jacob Steele here tonight? Here we go, ladies and gentlemen. This contest is on Strong Style Jacob Steele. Again, the one thing that those two men have done a lot of in their time here, Ron and Steele, is just talk. They haven't really backed up their actions. And there's MCL rolls it through. Kip up into Curry. So quick, so fast is MCL. MCL in his time away from OCW has really worked on his craft. He has really improved in there. And you're seeing it. The proof is in the pudding here. Here's MCL. Look at this with Strong Style. Oh! Inverted Alabama slam. Oh my God. Kick to the midsection. Steele immediately feeling the effect of that kick as he got hobbled, and he gets out of that precarious situation. Knife edge chop, another knife edge chop there from Strong Style. Forearm smash onto MCL. MCL the shot block, and then the knife edge chop of his own by MCL. Forearm smash there by MCL. Gonna take the striking battle to Strong Style. Jacob Steele in this contest sends him into the bottom right hand corner. This time, shoulder block to the midsection by MCL, and an overhead belly to belly suplex to follow on Jacob Steele, a cover to put Jacob Steele away here. No. Despite Steele not having the best of season this year, ladies and gentlemen, he is a former OCW champion. You cannot take that away from him. Kick to the midsection there by Strong Style, and a kick to the midsection. A running knee to the midsection, a forearm smash, another forearm smash, kick to the midsection, another kick to the midsection. Here comes Strong Style Jacob Steele, just looking good, lighting up the chest and body of MCL here with absolute ease. And there's a kick, blocked this time by MCL, turns around, now has Jacob Steele in the corner, big kick there by MCL. MCL now has him in position. Oh, and a sliding baseball drop kick to the inner hamstring of Jacob Steele. That will definitely do some damage. And now look at MCL, high elevation. Oh my God. Plants him down, high arching cover to put Jacob Steele away. And Steele able to get the shoulder up at two following that high elevation spike DDT from MCL. Now MCL as Jacob Steele, he's going to send him to the outside. Steele hit hard as MCL measures in the ring. MCL coming in hot. Drop kick through the middle there by MCL. MCL, great body control there to put that move in to really press. Oh my God. Oh, the face of Steele hit the top turnbuckle with that flapjack try cover kick out there by Steele. Steele still got fight in there, ladies and gentlemen. Kick to the back there by MCL. MCL now up on the middle. Up on the middle rope, he is calling for Jacob Steele to stand. Here comes MCL. Went for the forearm. Smash with Jacob Steele. Blocked it. Oh, and a wheel heel kick there by Jacob Steele, rocking MCL there. Forearm smash. Another forearm drops him down to one knee. Does Jacob Steele now steal? Oh, a reverse suplex. An inverted suplex cover on MCL to put him away here. No, and a kick out by MCL at two there by Strong Style Jacob. Jacob Steele not able to put him away there is what I should say. A couple of shots here by Steele. Irish whip sending him into the bottom left corner. Once again, here there's a kick to the ribs. Another kick to the ribs gets blocked by MCL. MCL now has Jacob Steele. He's going to send him. Oh, Steele hangs on. What the hell? MCL now on the middle. MCL in the middle. Look at the power. Look at the power of MCL. The deadlift Falcon Arrow from the middle rope. Incredible. And MCL follows up with that picture perfect frog splash cover to put Steele away and a kick out. My God, the resiliency of Steele on display. Jacob Steele now being brought up by MCL with a swinging DDT from MCL. And Jacob Steele is in a bad position here. And now MCL measures from opposite side of the ring. Oh my God! Oh my God! Dragon Twist Cutter! Good night, Steele! MCL impressive again! MCL once again showing the world why he is becoming one of the fastest rising stars here in OCW with a big, impressive win over Jacob Steele. And now MCL really looking to immortalization, and a lot of the guys in the All or Nothing ladder match better take notice of this young man, because he is not to be underestimated in this contest. He is definitely the underdog going into the All or Nothing, but that doesn't mean he can't pull out the win, ladies and gentlemen. Wait a second, ladies and gentlemen, Jacob Steele, he's grabbing a microphone. What does he have to say? What the hell? Jacob Steele is just quit. Jacob Steele is just quit OCW. Frustrations clearly have gotten the better of him, and Steele's walking out. What the hell? I gotta say, I did not expect that, ladies and gentlemen, at all. Jacob Steele has quit OCW. We will get more information on that as, you know, time goes on, but we're going backstage now. Penny Jacobs heading into Ace's office. Penny Jacobs will get a title shot next week against Skyfly for the NXT Women's Championship. And if any woman interferes for either side, both women will be fired from OCW. A lot on the line, and I hope for a very good, clean contest, ladies and gentlemen. And speaking of good, clean contests, ladies and gentlemen, up next in a number one contenders match for the Intercontinental title, Brett Storm will go up against FJA, and the winner will go to immortalization for the title. And making his way down to the ring first, ladies and gentlemen, for this number one contenders match for the Intercontinental Championship. He is a former Intercontinental Champion in his own right. He is the self-proclaimed savior of modern pro wrestling. This is Brett Storm. Brett Storm, this attitude and, you know, costume change has been all right for him so far, I guess. He's had a couple matches here at OCW. A lot of the fans have had mixed feelings about this man, but, you know, we'll see where his career here in OCW continues on. You know, we'll see what happens. We'll see what the future holds for this man. You know, it's too early to say where the trajectory of this new look Brett Storm will go. He did lose a qualifying match last week against Jonathan Morgan to get in the All or Nothing ladder match, but now he has another chance to go to immortalization here with this win over FJA. And making his way down to the ring next, ladies and gentlemen, he too is a former OCW Intercontinental Champion. This is FJA. FJA has been one of the most improved superstars in his time since debuting. He came in as a very inexperienced young lion, but over time he has really come around. He has really become somebody the fans can get behind. He is a former Intercontinental Champion, for God's sakes. That is a prestigious title here in OCW. Been around since 2012. And now FJA has another opportunity to get that title back. Remember, it was last year at WrestleMania 2 was where FJA defeated longstanding veteran Nightmare for the Intercontinental Championship. And that match really put him on the map. You know I'll give you one for free. And we will see which one of these two men will go back for one other opportunity for the Intercontinental Championship. And here we go, ladies and gentlemen. This contest is on. Collar and elbow tie-up gets us going here as FJA goes behind on Brett Storm with a waist lock. Brett Storm able to quickly switch his hips, goes behind on FJA. There's a waist lock takedown there by Brett. Brett and FJA jockeying for position here in this chain wrestle here. Now FJA now back to a vertical base with a side headlock on Brett. Brett gonna back FJA off the left-hand side, sends him off the right-hand side with an Irish whip, ducks under to his Brett Storm, leapfrogs over on the rebound, and here comes FJA. Brett Storm hooked him up and sending him over the top. On the rebound, Brett Storm was there to meet him, and he sent him hard to the outside. Ref's count begins as they get back into the ring quickly. Brett Storm is just trying to establish his positioning. And now look at this from Brett Storm. Hooked him up and just dropped him down. Trying to target the knee, trying to target the lower extremities of FJA to lock him into the Storm knee bar. These two men have met once before here on Renegade. It was Brett Storm who got the win via submission, and there's an enziguri there by FJA. FJA now bringing Brett Storm up. There's a forearm smash, roundhouse kick, another roundhouse kick there by FJA. There's a shot to the ribs, another shot to the ribs there by FJA. FJA has Brett Storm positioned. Middle rope tornado DDT there by FJA. A cover here on Brett Storm to put him away. That's two. Kick out there by Brett Storm. FJA unable to put him away here as now he brings him up to a vertical base here. And now drop down. Fireman's carry takedown there by Brett Storm. And now a pick of the leg and the dragon whip there by Brett Storm. Rolling out to the outside of the ring is FJA. But Brett Storm going right out after him. Four block shot there by FJA. FJA was just trying to buy himself some breathing room, trying to buy himself some time. And Brett Storm was, these two men now jockeying on the outside. And a look at this. Oh, nice toss by FJA. Brett Storm feeling the effects of that. You saw that as he hit the outside hard. FJA now up on the apron. FJA up on the apron as Brett Storm going to pull himself up. FJA springboard dropkick. Beautiful. Catching Brett Storm right on the jaw. A cover here by FJA to put him away. And a kick out by Brett Storm. FJA unhappy about it. Brett Storm now up to one knee, FJA. FJA took a little too much time there to allow Brett Storm to get to his feet. There's a forearm smash on FJA. There's another forearm smash there by Brett. Brett with another pick of the leg. And now again, Brett Storm just working on the lower body of FJA. Trying to really apply that pressure. Just trying to really weaken the legs to take away not only the painkiller, the finishing move. But there's a shot to the lower back with that kick. But to weaken the legs, the Storm knee bar. The same move that put FJA away weeks ago. And now here's Brett Storm. Hooks him up, positions, and a suplex there. Vertical suplex there by Brett Storm. And the crowd clearly not behind him. They are behind FJA. I cannot say that I blame them. You know, this new attitude of Brett Storm has really kind of rubbed some people the wrong way. And I guess the crowd, people in the crowd definitely a relay to that, but there's a kick away there by MJF. JA comes in with a flying kick to the face. There of Brent Storm, and now a shot to the right arm, shot to the right elbow of Brent Storm by MJA. There's a forearm smash. Here comes MJA. MJA starting to rally. There's a couple of strikes in the crowd coming alive, and there's a clothesline there by MJA. MJA, and the crowd is really rallying behind this young man. This young man has that extra gear. He can shift into it any time. The suicide dive takes down Brent Storm on the outside, with the prize of going to immortalization looming in the background. Both of these men will do whatever it takes to get to that historic event, as now Brent Storm being called to his feet by MJA. Another springboard. Oh, and another springboard dropkick. Went to the well one too many times, and now Brent Storm kicking the dust in. The disrespect shown by Brent Storm to MJA. And now here's Brent Storm just pull. Oh, God. Just pulled him in face first on the top rope. A cover and a kick out by FJA. God, that looks nasty. When you hit that wire-like top rope, it is just vicious. And now look at Brent Storm. Look at Brent Storm just torquing that right leg. You see there, just trying to fold up FJA like an accordion, you know, just trying to wear down the body, but FJA able to roll it through, there's a clothesline taking Brent Storm down to the outside. Brent Storm in a bad position here as FJA calls for Brent Storm to stand, and now FJA gonna head up top, he's gonna go over the top rope, try, coming, whipping the judo kick, big clothesline from Brent on the outside. Brent avoided the kick from the top and hit him with a clothesline on the outside by Brent Storm. Brent Storm, they're gonna bring FJA into the middle of the ring here. And now FJA in a bad spot here. Look at that, there's a crossface by Brent Storm. A crossface from Brent Storm trying to put FJA away. FJA in a bad spot here. FJA gonna try to fight out of it. You gotta fight out of it if you want to go to rest. Immortalization, young man. You gotta fight out of a couple of elbows. Couple of elbows from FJA. FJA, oh, and a forearm smash there from Brent. Blocked there by FJA. Forearm smash from FJA. Here comes FJA trying to rally here, and look at FJA. Stunner! Cover! 1, 2 to put him away! Kick outs! A stunner by FJA off the ropes! Big kick from FJA! A cover! A big running Pele PK kick! A kick out by Brent Storm at 2.5. FJA thought he had the best opportunity there, but how much power is really in those legs? A big uppercut there from FJA as Brent Storm now in a bad position here. Here comes FJA. Oh, no! Brent Storm saw him coming. FJA hit hard on the outside. And now Brent Storm trying to... Oh, a big boot from Brent. Brent just took down FJA now. Now FJA is in a bad spot here. Brent Storm lining it up for knee bar. Storm knee bar. FJA tapped to this move weeks ago. Will the result be the same? Will FJA be able to find his way out of this? You gotta fight, FJA. You gotta fight, young man. You gotta fight out of it. FJA is able to escape it. He's able to escape. The match is still on. Big kick from FJA. The signature maneuver. That's one. That's two. Kick out by Brennan. 2. You had to think that was a desperation effort from FJA. To hit the big kick down to the top. Does he have enough? Brent Storm getting back to his feet. FJA having second thoughts. Big drop kick to the back. And Brent Storm back to his feet. Another uppercut there from FJA. FJA comes flying in. Nice. The crowd is rallying behind FJA. Oh, what a roundhouse. A roundhouse from FJA. Oh! got him in the drop zone! Drop zone pain! Killer! 1-2! MJA is going to immortalization! MJA does it! MJA now has a date for the Intercontinental title on the grandest stage once again! Congratulations to MJA on a hard... Wait a minute! Speaking of the Intercontinental title, the Intercontinental Champion, the Dark Shark, Alias, is making his entry! Alias won that title back in OCW, Never Back Down, over Jack Robertson. Now carries the title into immortalization as he is coming to meet his challenger face to face. Alias versus FJA on the grandest stage of them all. That's going to be one hell of a match, ladies and gentlemen. But Alias calling for a mic. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, here's a treat for you. An unexpected title match. Alias will defend the IC title right here, right now. In an open challenge, who's coming out? Who's going to accept? Here's an interesting matchup. A man who made his OCW return at the Royal Rumble, the former OCW United States Champion, OCW Original, this is Jake Hall. Maybe you can show me how to love. Maybe. Jake Hall, one of the purest high flyers in all of UCT. In his time away from OCW, he was able to hone his skills and competed in the EWF, even competed in the first ever EWF Deadly Games match that I had the pleasure of calling, and Jake Hall looked damn good in that match, and Alias better not take this man lightly, because Jake Hall could shock the world here tonight, ladies and gentlemen, and upset Alias and go to immortalization to face FJA for the Intercontinental title. And you know Jake Hall would love to get there. This is going to be a good match, ladies and gentlemen. A first time encounter between these two men. I'm excited to see these two lock up. Great to see Jake Hall back in an OCW ring as well, ladies and gentlemen. The Intercontinental Championship Open Challenge has been answered. And Jake Hall ready for the challenge. He looks ready. He is excited, I'm sure. And he, you know, the crowd, they're excited to see this man back here in OCW for sure. But the Dark Shark, Alias, not gonna give up that championship lightly. The winner of this match will see FJA at the Showcase of Immortals Immortalization. A lot is on the line here tonight, not only for the title, but for the grandest stage. Only one will go. As Alias hands the title belt over, this is Alias's first title defense of the Intercontinental Championship. You would hate to see him lose that title on his first defense, but it's very, very possible. It's been done before, and it'll be done again. But will it happen tonight? Here we go. Let's find out, ladies and gentlemen. This match is on. Both men come to the center of the ring. Collar and elbow tie-up gets us going. Jake Hall has the arm of Alias, and now Alias getting brought down to one knee. Jake Hall continuing the pressure, continuing the pressure on the arm, and now Alias with a drop down to a side armbar of his own, and Jake Hall quickly able to roll out of it. He wants Alias to bring it. Alias goes behind now on Jake Hall. As the Intercontinental Champion, Jake Hall able to switch his hips, goes behind on Alias, does the challenger. Both men jockeying for position here, trying to get the better of one another. The headlock takeover, thereby Alias onto Jake Hall, and now wrenching it in, and a knee to the back, stiff knee to the back, there by the Dark Shark Intercontinental Champion Alias. And now here comes Jake Hall, big shot, rocking Alias there. And now Jake Hall wants Alias to bring it on. Here comes a forearm smash there from Alias. Here comes a forearm smash from Jake Hall. These two men gonna go back and forth, striking battle. The crowd is coming alive for these two men going at it. Shot there, another shot there from Jake Hall, spinning back kick to the midsection there by Jake Hall. Jake Hall, Irish whip, gonna send Alias off the top side, ducks under, does Jake Hall off the rebound, leapfrogs over, does Jake Hall, and now Jake Hall, look at this, nice German suplex. The OCW originals have really gotten better in their time away here, ladies and gentlemen, and it's exciting to see what they bring to the table here, and Alias goes over, float over, DDT! Float over DDT, thereby Alias a quick cover here on Jake Hall to retain the Intercontinental Championship here tonight. Kick out there by Jake Hall. Jake Hall getting back to his feet quickly, blocked a shot. Did Jake Hall, there's a shot to the face of Alias. Irish whip gonna send him off the left hand side this time. One extension on that big boot from Jake Hall. The pump kick and a cover and a kick out by Alias just in the nick of time. Gets the shoulder up. Jake Hall, the flexibility, the dexterity on display there. Now has him in the bottom left-hand corner, does Jake Hall. Jake Hall, the kick to the midsection and another kick to the midsection there by Jake. Irish whip gonna send him in the top right-hand corner. Opposite side, step up, enziguri in the corner there by Jake Hall. Alias in a bad spot here, and a clothesline from Jake. Jake Hall takes Alias down to the outside. Jake Hall now in control of the Intercontinental Champion. Jake Hall running around like a madman. Here comes Jake Hall! Step up tornado senton to the outside by Jake Hall. Like I said, one of the most purest flyers in all of OCW. Alias slowly making his way back up to his feet. Forearm met with a forearm smash and an uppercut to follow up there by Jake Hall. Jake Hall now going to send Alias back out to the outside. Remember, Jake Hall loves to fly. Alias in a bad spot here as Jake Hall measures. Jake Hall measures Alias off the ropes. Comes Jake Hall. Oh! Met with an open palm strike counter by Alias. Alias well out of the cover. Here on Jake Hall to put him away. No, that was a good chance for Alias. That was smart, trying to catch him off guard, trying to put him away following that. And now look at this, hooked him up. Oh, what a power bomb! What a power bomb from Alias. A cover on Jake Hall to put him away and a kick out. Jake Hall, that showing his heart. He's not gonna go down that easily. He rolls out of it. Look at this nice head scissors whip there by Jake Hall. Jake Hall now gonna head up top. Jake Hall gonna head up to the high risk district. Moonsault City, baby, cover here on Alias to win the Intercontinental Championship here, and a kick out by Alias at two. A kick out by Alias at two. Jake Hall measures him to his feet. Here comes Jake Hall. Jake Hall's got the head of Alias. Alias able to get out of it. There's a takedown there by Alias onto Jake Hall. The Intercontinental Champion coming alive. There's an enziguri of his own by Alias on Jake Hall. And now Alias, what's he got in mind here as he brings him up one more time? Irish whip gonna send Jake Hall into the bottom in the top right corner here as he brings him up to a seated position on the top rope, swings his legs out, and now Alias up on the middle with Jake Hall. Oh, a backbreaker over the top turnbuckle, and now Alias up top, turns around, Moonsault City, baby, again. Anything you can do, I can do better. A cover to retain the title. No. So close for the Dark Shark to put Jake Holloway here. And now here's the aliens with a single leg Boston Crab. Single leg Boston Crab trying to put Jake Holloway, trying to put him away. Is alias Jake Hall is in a bad spot here. He's got to try to get out of this. He's got to fight out of this. He's got to fight out of the crab. He's able to roll Ackerman on his back and kicks alias away. The match for the IC title still underway. The title still hangs in the balance here as Jake Hall rallies with a couple of shots. And alias pushes Jake Hall away. Here comes Jake Hall. Alias, oh my God, look at this. Oh, sit up tombstone. Sit up tombstone. A cover to put Jake Hall away and a kick out. A kick out at 2.5 by Jake Hall, the challenger. And now Jake Hall is rocked, but he's trying to fight. He's trying to get back to his feet. Back elbow there from Jake Hall. Rolling discus forearm. Discus forearm on alias. Jake Hall. Jake Hall. Oh, Fisherman neckbreaker. Now brings him up and a kick to the back there by Jake Hall. Jake Hall staying on the offense, the knee to the lower back this time of alias. And now Jake Hall with another shot to the lower back. And now look at this standing shooting star press. Standing shooting star press from Jake Hall. Jake Hall, red arrow. Going for the red arrow. Jake Hall calling for alias to stand. Jake Hall! Alias leaped up and the forearm just dropped him like a bad habit. Oh my God. Alias now measures Jake Hall. Now measures clothesline from hell. And Alias punches his ticket to immortalization. It's a huge win tonight for the Intercontinental title. And now, ladies and gentlemen, the matchup is official for the Intercontinental title. Alias will defend the title against FJA on the grandest stage of them all. Congratulations to both men, as I'm sure that match will be an incredible contest, but Alias can rest a little easier now knowing that he has gotten his first defense of the Intercontinental Championship under his belt. Congratulations to the Dark Shark. Congratulations, and will the result be the same at Immortalization, or will we see a new Intercontinental Champion in the form of FJA? We will find out, ladies and gentlemen. That match is going to be absolutely incredible. A great night so far, ladies and gentlemen. And we have one more match to come for you later tonight. The NXT Championship will go on the line in that Extreme Rules match. I'll go backstage with Wigman. This fucking guy! He did this shit last week too! For fuck's sakes, just tell us already! God! I'll go backstage with Jenna this time. Challenge to her former partner for next week for the featherweight title. We will wait to hear what Ashley Punk has to say about that, ladies and gentlemen. But that match is going to be intense when those two finally decide to lock it up. We will see if it's next week. And making their way out to the ring next, ladies and gentlemen. Last week they said they were going to come out and address the tag division. They are the current OCW Tag Team Champions. Mario Sanchez, DJ Hero, the Dynasty are here. ever since winning those tag team titles, they have elevated the tag team division here in OCW tenfold. The demand for OCW tag team wrestling is at an all-time high, ladies and gentlemen. It is thanks to these two men, and now they have come out to address their title match that is only bound to happen at Immortalization, but we do not know who is going to be challenging them, and I'm sure that is why they are here tonight to let us know. Hopefully, we'll see. I don't know what's to happen, but they are both calling for microphones, and we will hear from the Dynasty, and I'm very excited to hear what in fact they have to say. So let's send it over to them. The Dynasty, and we will hear from them right now. They are calling for microphones as well. Yeah, let's do it. These two teams staring off. Let's do it. Let's do it. What? Wait a minute. Hold on, ladies and gentlemen. Before they can get a word in, here comes Chris Azure. Justice X. Azure Justice are here. One of the fastest rising popular tag teams in all of UCT. They got something to say about this as well. Maybe they're throwing their names in to be considered to face the Dynasty once again for the tag team titles. And now they are both calling for microphones as well. All the teams want a shot at the tag titles for Immortalization. I can't blame them. Asher Justice throwing their names in to face off for the tag team championships as well, but it is up to the Dynasty as to who they face. Who is it going to be? Well, there you have it, ladies and gentlemen. The Dynasty have chosen the Hardcore Hate Crew in a rematch from Implosion. What? Wait a minute! What? Ladies and gentlemen, what is going on? Next week, Azure Justice versus the Hardcore Hate Crew and Renegade 16, the Dynasty defended an open challenge, and at Immortalization, if every piece is still there, we will have the Dynasty versus the Hardcore Hate Crew versus Azure Justice for the tag team titles in a triple threat tag team match. Oh my God, sign me up. But ladies and gentlemen, it is main event time. Extreme Rules for the OCW NXT Championship, AJ Reyes, Manny Lopez. Let's go. Making his way down to the ring first, ladies and gentlemen, he is the challenger. He is a fourth OCW NXT champion. This is AJ Reyes. AJ Reyes has certainly had a career resurgence in the year 2020. He has had some great matches here in OCW and now looking to become a two-time OCW NXT champion. These two men, you know, Ingobernables, stable members in other federations like the AWC, like the PASW. But now, the brotherhood has been put aside in pursuit of personal gain. In the terms of Manny Lopez, Manny Lopez has certainly kicked that to the curb here, but this is business, but it is personal now as well, ladies and gentlemen. And these two men are about to tear it up and tear each other apart. Whatever respect, whatever love between them existed before is definitely gone now. And making his way down to the ring next, ladies and gentlemen, he is the reign defending OCW NXT champion. This is Manny Lopez. Manny Lopez stole the NXT, yes, stole the NXT championship from AJ Reyes at OCW Implosion. Thanks to that mystery man who appeared in the audience. And to be honest, ladies and gentlemen, we still have no idea who the fuck that was. All this time, we still have no idea who that was. We have not seen anything like it since that time. So you have to think that Manny Lopez paid whoever the fuck that was off to come out and cause some sort of distraction to provide Manny Lopez the opportunity to become OCW NXT champion. But will Manny Lopez be able to get out of this one with the NXT championship still around his waist? Remember, no countouts, no disqualifications. The only way to win is by pinfall or submission in the dead center of the ring. And this match, like I said, ladies and gentlemen, this match is going to be hard-hitting. It is going to be intense. Again, there is no love lost between these two men. Yeah, I'll say it till the cows come home, ladies and gentlemen. That's just how it is. You know, it's going to be a brutal contest. And I hope y'all are ready. Hope y'all are ready for this, for the NXT Championship. Both men know exactly what this title means to them. And, you know, this... Manny said it best last week when he said this title represents their resurgences here in OCW. AJ Reyes made his return at the top of the season, and Manny Lopez, with this new attitude change, really has elevated his game. And AJ Reyes, you know, he looks focused. He looks ready to go. The crowd certainly behind the man. As Manny Lopez now readies himself in the corner, he is getting psyched. He is getting in his head. He is getting He's getting into that zone, that place he needs to go in order to retain the OCW NXT Championship tonight, ladies and gentlemen. He's gonna have to do whatever it takes to win. Both men are gonna have to do whatever it takes to win, because you know the other is not gonna go down easy. You know it. Everybody should know that this is not gonna be an easy win. Now let's see who's gonna come out on top for the NXT Championship. Both men ready. And the match is on here, and AJ Reyes comes out of the corner with a dropkick to the chest there of Manny Lopez, and now bringing him up, forearm smash. Here comes AJ Reyes lighting up Manny Lopez. AJ Reyes coming out firing, coming out with some intensity. He is just unleashing months of anger and pent-up frustration of not being able to get his hands on Manny. Manny rolls out to the ring trying to buy himself some time, and AJ Reyes comes off the top with a diving clothesline, taking Manny Lopez down. Manny Lopez is rocked, slowly gets up to his feet. There's a shot blocked by Manny. Manny now going to Irish with AJ into the guardrail on the outside. And a sentiment into the turnbuckle post on the outside of the ring. Bow! It just smashes his head over the LED turnbuckle post on the outside. There's a head scissors whip there by Manny Lopez on the outside. Remember, no countouts, no disqualification. Standardized wrestling rules of extreme wrestling contest. Hurricane Rana. Manny Lopez now going to head up to the apron there, measuring AJ Reyes. Here comes Manny! Springboard dropkick to the back of AJ Reyes, who was trying to get up to his feet. Now Manny Lopez going under the ring for some hardware. We got the table! Go! And AJ gets the table to the face! Jesus Christ! Manny Lopez just cracked AJ Reyes right across the face, and now AJ rolls it through on Manny Lopez. Look at the power bomb! One-arm power bomb on the outside by AJ. AJ now bringing Manny Lopez up to a vertical base, going to send him into the ring. Does AJ now up on the apron. Manny Lopez up to his feet now, and look at AJ, nice slingshot corkscrew cross body to the inside of the ring from the apron by AJ Reyes. Manny Lopez pull himself up in a shoulder block takedown, sends Manny Lopez hard to the outside. AJ Reyes now calling for him to stand. Here comes AJ! AJ Reyes like a fine wine, ladies and gentlemen. He has only gotten better with age. And now he proves it day in and day out in this past year. He has done some incredible things. He just bounces Manny Lopez's head off the LED and a kick to the midsection there by Manny. Here comes Manny Meteora on the outside by Manny Lopez. Viciousness on display by Manny Lopez. Manny now going to bring AJ into the center of the ring here. Going to bring him out to a vertical base. Another move there. Another head scissors whip takedown there by Manny Lopez on AJ Reyes. AJ back to his feet. Now look at this revolution head scissors this time by Manny Lopez. AJ rolled to the outside, and Manny saw Adams well scouted, vaulted the top rope with ease and took AJ Reyes down, now sending him off the guardrail on the outside. It's a gurry. Rocking AJ Reyes is Manny Lopez, and a wheel kick to follow on AJ. Now going back under the ring for more hardware is Manny. Now Manny's got a sledge. Manny's got a sledge. The weapon that AJ Reyes attacked him with at Cyber Vengeance. And now Manny Lopez getting himself a little bit of retribution, just dropping the fist, dropping the hammer down across the chest, just taunting the fans, taunting AJ Reyes. And now Manny gonna bring him into the center of the ring. Once again, AJ Reyes feeling the effects. He's slowly getting to his feet as Manny Lopez gets a ladder. He's just pulling everything out. And now AJ Reyes running around. And a block shot there from AJ. AJ now has Manny. Oh! A suplex on the ladder! A suplex on the ladder! A cover to put him away! A kick out by Manny! Oh my God, yeah, the back of it. Manny Lopez has got to be screaming in agony. Oh, and a table across the ribs, across the midsection by AJ to Manny. Forearm blocked there by Manny Lopez. Manny Lopez still has some fight. He still has heart. He sends him into the corner. Dropkick. Oh, my God. Oh, my God. The dropkick broke the table. A cover and a kick out. Manny dropkicked AJ so hard he broke the table. Hurricane Rana. The Rana from Manny Lopez on AJ Reyes. A nice move and another Hurricane Rana there by Manny Lopez. Manny Lopez just yelling at AJ Reyes to stay down. Now Manny going up to the apron now. Here comes Springboard Frog Splash. Springboard Frog Splash keeping AJ Reyes down even further. The pain that AJ's got to be in as Manny goes back under the ring again. Manny has incorporated a ton of weaponry into this match, and now a second table has been brought into the equation. Kick to the midsection there by Manny. Manny, look at this sunset flip powerbomb on the legs of the ladder. Oh my God, a cover to put him away. A kick out by AJ. AJ got the shoulder up in the, oh my God, that was so close. That was so fucking close. Now in the bottom left hand corner is Manny with AJ. AJ had the leg. Dragon Whip sending him into the turnbuckle. The Dragon Whip into the turnbuckle from Manny. On Manny, and a knife head shot. Knife head shot again by AJ Reyes in the corner. AJ now going to bring Manny up to a seated position on the table. On the turnbuckle. Oh, step up kick to the side of the head. From AJ Reyes. Now AJ up top. AJ gonna go up top. What's he got in mind? What does he have in mind? Oh! Cover! To put him away! Kick out! AJ Reyes unable to put Manny Lopez away. That was a very, very good try as he goes for the table once again. And another shot to the midsection. Using the table and driving it into the midsection, driving the air out of Manny Lopez, and now has the table set up. Dire intentions are on the mind of AJ Reyes, but blocked there from Manny. Manny Lopez takes a shot to the midsection there from AJ. A drop kick to the chest of Manny Lopez by AJ Reyes. Now bringing up Manny as AJ. Kick to the midsection there by Manny. Manny comes in, look at this running revolution head scissors by Manny Lopez. Now Manny Lopez heading up top, 450! The 450 on display, a cover to put him away, and a kick out! A kick out by AJ Reyes. And now Manny Lopez once again going after that ladder. Ladder, the shot there to AJ. He's feeling the effects of that one, and now he rolls out of it. He kind of got a little bit of claw. Oh, he got clipped a little bit, but that 1 minute's mark full force. Now the ladder is set up in the dead center. The table is set up in the ring as well. One can only imagine what's going through the mind of these two men, what they won't do to each other to put the other one away. Irish Whip sending Manny off the ropes, and there's a tilt-a-whirl high angle backbreaker over the knee by AJ on Manny. Shot block kick to the midsection there by Manny Lopez. Now Manny Lopez comes flying in with a drop kick of his own to the chest of AJ Reyes. Now forearm got block kicked in the midsection there on Manny Lopez. Manny really feeling the effects. But AJ staying on the assault, staying on the offense. And now, but Manny's trying to get to higher ground. This battle now will take place above the ring. Forearm smash. These two men battling above the ring. Manny Lopez trying to escape to higher ground. AJ Reyes, the table is right underneath AJ. These two men battling. AJ Reyes now has Manny. Has him up. Oh my God! A neck breaker from the top through the table goes Manny. Manny Lopez is not moved. AJ Reyes has him right where he wants him. He's just staring down at his Ingobernables brother to put the final nail in the coffin. Looking for neutralizer. Looking for neutralizer. Neutralizer on Manny. A cover to win the NXT title. That's one. That's two. AJ Reyes is a champion again. AJ Reyes, a two-time NXT champion, and puts Manny Lopez away, puts this rivalry to bed. On a positive note, does AJ Reyes... Wait a second. What the hell? Wait a minute, ladies and gentlemen. The Ace! What the hell is Johnny Extreme doing out here? Johnny Extreme made his OCW return at the Royal Rumble at number 30. Got to the final three, eliminated five men in the contest, and now he's coming down here. You know, AJ Reyes just had a hard-fought match against Manny Lopez, a brutal affair. And, you know, I hate for this to break down, but we've never known Johnny Extreme to do that here in OCW. He's always been a stand-up guy, but he's got a microphone, so let's see what he has to say. AJ Reyes, Johnny Extreme, Renegade 16 for the NXT Championship. That is going to be epic, ladies and gentlemen. Well, ladies and gentlemen, that is our show. Thank you all for tuning in. We will see you next week for Renegade 15.